Racing to the 2024 Kentucky Derby, and this time, let's get an update on Sunday, April the 21st, a big weekend of work Saturday and Sunday, along with some open gallops at Churchill Downs. 17 of the horses have arrived at the Kentucky Derby grounds, still waiting on Fierceness, possibly Grand Mo the first if he gets into the race, and also a couple of Oaks horses still making their way. Today we'll take a look at some of those workouts, give some analysis. Also, we had a viewer wanted to talk about the Sierra Leone Stride. We'll kind of zoom in and take a look at his workout on Saturday and show you that paddle on his front left leg. So let's get right down to it. Still on deck for the Kentucky Derby. Grand Mo the first and Common Defense waiting to get into the field. No official word if Encino is going to be going. Endlessly did work on Saturday, and no announcement after that work if he is going to the Derby or the American Turf. Now, the video courtesy of Churchill Downs, let's take a look at some of these workouts. First off, on the Oak side, Sunday morning, this is what's called a quarter mile blowout. You'll hear the term, and really what it is kind of a quarter mile gallop, about the last eighth of a mile before the finish line, through the finish line. And a lot of times horses used to do this in the past, kind of 1 or 2 days before the race. Where's my ring? Gonna have one more final workout before the Oaks. Now, Track Phantom went 5 furlongs in company on Sunday for trainer Steve Asmussen. You know, is he gonna bring some early speed to the pace? We did a video on him on Saturday if you want to see kind of his races and how he got to the Derby. Track Phantom, kind of been lightly trained coming into this Derby. He raced himself into shape by running in 4 stakes races down at the fairgrounds. Now, Forever Young, the pride of Japan, he's been here a week now. He galloped on Saturday. The big news for Forever Young, he is going to have his first timed workout on Tuesday beneath the twin spires of Churchill Downs. Now we go to Torpedo Anna. Ken McPeak says you better bring a bear because he's bringing the grizzly. He is going to bring Torpedo Anna into this race after a win in the Fantasy Stakes. He's confident, thinks she's going to run well. Of course, she's got a couple of wins at Churchill Downs. She's 3-for-4 lifetime. She's got some 8, 7, 5, 6, 7, 8 length wins. So Torpedo Anna, all systems go from trainer Ken McPeak. We'll see if anybody can bring the bear on Oaks Day, Friday, May 3rd. Now, Mystik Dan. Of course, he's by Golden Sense, trained by Ken McPeak. He worked 5 furlongs in company. You know, kind of an average workout. Was looking to see a little bit more out of him, especially a stronger gallop out, but he's in shape. He ran in the Arkansas Derby, looks good coat-wise, and perfect training weather on Saturday at Churchill Downs along with Sunday. Now, Door Knock, this one was a good work. He worked 4 furlongs in company, kind of breezed through the lane, but I was expecting to see a lot more from Door Knock. Remember, he ran off the pace, ran out of the money in the Bluegrass Stakes, kind of a disappointing effort in the Fountain of Youth. I really wanted to see a 5 furlong move, a little bit more speed, see if he kind of has some of his mojo from his 2-year-old campaign. But I think this is a horse who's kind of regressed, and unless I see something change in the next 10 days, I think Door Knock is not going to be on my tickets. Now, Just a Touch, he went 4 furlongs. Now, you're going to say this is the same move that Door Knock did. The only difference is Just a Touch got more out of his race in the Bluegrass. He showed more speed, chased a faster pace. What I like about this is a solo move, and with speed horses, a lot of times they'll go solo. So whenever you see kind of a speed horse go in company, it's kind of rare. Just a Touch, I think he's in form. Didn't need to see as much from here since he ran a big race in the Bluegrass race, but he still only got 3 lifetime starts and did not race as a 2-year-old. Let's take a look at Sierra Leone, the son of Gunrunner. Of course, Gunrunner was a horse of the year, won the Pegasus World Cup, won the Breeders' Cup Classic, also ran 3rd in the Kentucky Derby, 2nd in the Dubai World Cup. Sierra Leone, $2.3 million yearling. He's out of a Malibu Moonmare, 3-for-4 lifetime, trained by Chad Brown. Somebody wanted to talk about his paddle. Now, there's been some videos out there. We're going to try to zoom in, show it to you if you have not seen it. He kind of swings around his front left foot. Now, it's not the most efficient move, but horses run like this all the time in other races throughout the year. So we'll take a look at Sierra Leone and his paddle foot. But since we got a good workout on him on Saturday, I wanted to zoom in, point out a couple of things that I like about this workout. One, Very shiny coat, seems very healthy. Two, wanted to show you, I've talked about the fork. This is that deep muscle in the rear end, and you kind of get this just from training. Kind of zoom in on it here. You notice this big fork there, and that's a powerful sign that he's in shape, ready to take on the 10 furlongs of the Kentucky Derby. He went 5 furlongs in company, but Sierra Leone looked good in this workout. Now let's zoom in on the paddle and take a look at what's going on here. What you see is his front left foot kind of swings around, and they call this a paddle. Now, horses, you know, in cheaper races, allowance races. Now, do I think it's going to affect him at 10 furlongs? Yes, I do think it's inefficient and he's going to be running farther than he's ever ran. But in terms of affecting his speed rating, I think maybe might affect it a little bit late in the race. My biggest concern with Sierra Leone is coming from behind, being a stretch runner. Normally, you just don't see a really good horse that's a stretch runner. A lot of these other horses that have ran well, been hyped up the last few years, a lot of the favorites are more speed type horses, so you just very rarely see a stretch runner being bet down in the Kentucky Derby. So that's what's going to be interesting, but I don't think he'll have a long career just because horses with these paddles, normally they run 2, 3, 4 times, they give them time off, they run 2, 3, 4 times, then they give them some more time off. So we'll see if Sierra Leone can make it through the Triple Crown Series. If he doesn't win the Derby, he probably won't run in the Preakness anyways. So we'll see Sierra Leone. Now, lots more workouts coming this week. Projected odds, it looks like Fierceness favored in Vegas. Sierra Leone at 7-2. Forever Young at 7-1. Catching Freedom right around 9-1. And we've still got a lot of news coming up in the next couple of weeks. Post positions drawn next Saturday, April 27th. Opening night at Churchill Downs. We got the Derby Pedigree Show on April 29th. Derby Handicapping Show on April 30th, then the Kentucky Oaks on May 3rd, May 4th, the Kentucky Derby. Then we'll go live after the race to talk about if anybody won money, what happened in the race, and kind of quickly recap the Kentucky Derby. Triple Crown Prospectus comes out every Monday, 2,000 words on the Triple Crowns and three-year-old. That goes through the Belmont Stakes, still time to sign up, and look for it in the link below at the description. Kentucky Derby Pedigree Show, April 29th. If you can't join us live at 7 o'clock Central, Jessica Tugwell and I, she'll go through all of the Derby horses, talk about microdonatal DNA and female families and all that good stuff. She's a pedigree analyst. And don't forget, I've got the running style of the contenders, speed figures up, historical prep races, and still more to come this week on the channel. What do you think of the Sierra Leone paddle? What do you think of some of the weekend workouts? Leave a comment as we get you ready for Derby 2024. Dwayne Lucas says, people have opinions, horses have the facts.